Question 1.1 consists of 5 finance questions that were designed to assess your understanding of personal budgets, income, expense, and UIF. You are given a personal budget in Table 1 that lists the income and expense per month for an individual. In question 1.1.1, you have to define the term net salary. The net salary is the salary received after deductions are made. In question 1.1.2, you have to name one of Mrs. Smut's expenses that are deductible before tax is calculated. From the list of expenses in Table 1, the expense that is deductible before tax is calculated is the pension fund. In question 1.1.3, it is stated that a monthly contribution is made to the unemployment insurance fund. You will have to write down the percentage of the total contribution that will be paid to the UIF. The total UIF contribution is 2% of a person's gross salary. Remember that the gross salary is the salary before deductions are made. Of the 2%, 1% is taken from the person's gross salary and another 1% is taken from the company that the person works for. This question asks for the total contribution that will be made to the UIF. This will be 2%. Question 1.2 consists of 2 finance questions that were designed to assess your understanding of hire purchase agreements. You're given an advert for a tractor that's available on hire purchase. Option 1 has a repayment term of 36 monthly payments, 0% deposit, and a hire purchase amount including VAT of 63,300 Rand per month. Option 2 has a repayment term of 3 annual or yearly payments, a 10% deposit, and a hire purchase amount including VAT of 633,000 Rand per year. In question 1.2.1, you have to define the term hire purchase in the given context. Here the context part is important, and simply writing down the general definition of the term hire purchase won't get you the marks. You have to define the term hire purchase in the context of this advertisement. Here the definition of hire purchase is when a tractor is bought and then paid off over a period of time. In question 1.2.2, you have to write down the monthly repayment amount if Mr. Smuts decides to buy this tractor. From the advertisement, the monthly repayment amount is given as 63,300 Rand. Question 1.3 consists of 5 finance questions designed to assess your understanding of tax invoices and interest rates. You are given a till slip listing items bought at a grocery store. In question 1.3.1, you have to name one item that Mrs. Smuts paid for that will not be used for baking malt tarts. From the list of items bought, we see that the 2 plastic bags are the only items that are not ingredients used for baking malt tarts. In question 1.3.2, you are instructed to write out the acronym VAT in words. VAT stands for Value Added Tax. In question 1.3.3, you are instructed to write down the payment method used by Mrs. Smuts. We see here that the payment method used was cash. In question 1.3.4, you are instructed to calculate the unit price per egg. The unit price of the egg is the price of 1 egg. From the till slip, we see that a tray of 30 eggs costs 74.99. So the cost price of 1 egg is 74.99 divided by 30 eggs, and this equals a unit cost of 2.50 per egg. In question 1.3.5, it is stated that Mrs. Smuts receives 2,000 Rand a month for baking malt tarts for the farm stall. She decides to invest this money in a bank that offers a compound interest rate of 0.5% per month. You are instructed to calculate the interest amount she will receive in the first month. The interest amount she will receive in the first month equals the principal amount of 2,000 Rand multiplied by the interest rate of 0.5 over 100 and this equals an interest amount of 10 Rand. Question 1.4 consists of three data handling questions designed to assess your understanding of pie charts. You are given a pie chart of the different types of farms in the Western Cape. You're also given a table with the different types of farms and their respective agricultural share in percentages. In question 1.4.1, you have to write down the most common type of farming in the Western Cape. From the pie chart or table, we see that the most common type of farming in the Western Cape is fruit farming. In question 1.4.2, you are instructed to write down the percentage of farming that is represented by vegetable farming. From the table, the percentage of farming that is represented by vegetable farming is 12%. In question 1.4.3, you have to write down what other type of graph could be used to illustrate this data. Another type of graph that can be used to illustrate this data would be a bar graph. Question 1.5 consists of two data handling questions that were designed to assess your understanding of box and whisker plots. You are given two box and whisker plots that represent how satisfied employees on a farm are with their current working conditions. The workers from each department were asked to rate their job satisfaction on a scale from 0% to 100%. The findings of the result at the two departments on the farm are shown in the box and whisker plots. In question 1.5.1, you have to classify the data as numerical or categorical. Numerical data is data that can be counted or measured, while categorical data is data that can be placed into categories. In this survey, the workers were asked to rate their job satisfaction on a scale from 0 to 100%, which is measurable. For this reason, we have to say that the type of data given can be classified as numerical data. In question 1.5.2, you have to write down the value of the upper quartile, also known as quartile 3 of Department B. There are three quartiles in a box and whisker plot. The lower quartile, also known as quartile 1 or the 25th percentile, the median, also known as quartile 2 or the 50th percentile, and lastly, the upper quartile, also known as quartile 3 or the 75th percentile. These quartiles are given by these lines on the box and whisker plot, respectively. Now, the upper quartile of Department B can be read off the graph as 75%. As a bonus tip, these lines on the box and whisker plot represents the lowest and highest value in the survey. This means that the lowest rating given by the workers in Department B was 40%, and the highest rating given by the workers in Department B was 80%. The range of this data set can be calculated by finding the difference between these values. So the range for Department B equals 80% minus 40%, and this equals a range of 40%. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. And if you found this video helpful, you can subscribe to be notified of more videos like this. And you can check out this video next.